Hello and welcome back to the Wasteland 3. I'm here with Aukki and we are back. Back in the Colorado Springs.
Yes, we are back in this hellhole.
Well,
and this cat is following me.
We are currently here with the Patriarch's Marshals and we are... Well, are you neutral with them? I'm like a little bit evil with them.
Yes, we are neutral.
Yes.
We have fame.
And our fame is a bit pretty low, my friend.
Yeah,
not very like it.
So, what should we do?
No, well, my friend, we shall go inside to meet this Russian guy.
Wait, there's this woman.
Who is this woman? Oh, I forgot my Jody
friend. I need to rest a spell.
I will give you the leadership.
Catch my breath. That all right with you?
How are your injuries? Are you recovering okay? I tried my best when I cured you.
Now you are more better, Thor.
I'm still healing up. Go out and find your footing while I get back on my feet.
So, are you missing Arizona?
Arizona.
Oh man, more every day.
By the way, she is a sniper
nice
as well.
Kind of majestic with all the mountains and wild weather, but it's hard to enjoy it when I know everybody back home is dying by inches. We gotta finish up our business with the Patriarch and get the supplies he promised us back home. People are counting on us. My folks are counting on us. Sorry, I just want to get this done and get back to them.
So, talk to you later, Jody. We are gonna check this place out.
Later.
My friend, she's gonna take your sniper spot because you are missing too much.
What am I missing?
The shots, my friend.
Nah, I have 90% hit chance.
Yes, my friend. I shall not make sudden moves.
No sudden moves around.
I will not attack him, my friend. Who is this?
Wait, can I shoot
him? Pleased to meet you, Rangers.
Nice to meet you too, Diligent Joe.
Welcome, Rangers. I'm Marshal Darius Kwan, and this here's Sergei Gretzky.
Good to meet you, Rangers. Glad to see some friendly faces. Been rough around here these last few days.
Oh.
Dorsey's attacked us too. Snuck inside Colorado Springs and killed a lot of people. Situation's under control now, mostly.
So, what were the Dorseys after?
The Patriarch. Thank God they never got near him. He's the only thing keeping Colorado from tearing itself apart.
Oh.
And sorry about these alarms. Something must have triggered the old security system. Trouble is, there's a bunch of angry robots guarding the computer that shuts them off. How you deal with them is your call. Your base, your rules.
So, there is angry robots? Why are there angry robots, my friend?
Yeah, weird, huh? They weren't active when we looked the place over a few days back, but... Let's talk after you kill the alarms. I can hardly
hear myself.
Yeah,
they're giving us the job.
Yes, because this is now our base, my friend. We own this shit.
Okay, let's go. Where is it?
Wait a second, my friend. There is two doors here. Shall we check this door first? Can you open it?
I cannot pick lock it. It's impossible.
Son of a bitch.
I mean, it's impossible to open it.
You are just too weak.
That is impossible. Hey, there's something
then,
here. Cannot go there. We cannot go there.
Then we shall go here, my friend. Let the Chronicle. Oh shit. There is very angry robot.
That's you sneaky shit.
This is pretty good Friday, my friend.
Shall we use the sneaky shit?
We are the Arizona Rangers, a successor unit of the US Army Corps of Engineers. We are the government representatives.
Chose that.
You do that. You have a very slow Google, my friend. Thank you, my friend robot. See, my friend, you'd have to be sneaky when you own this place.
Alright, let's do it.
Wait a second, what are you doing? There was much to load.
As it boots up, a security alert flashes across the display. Every attempt to access a menu is met with a command access only. Eventually, you query the machine for command identity. It replies, command empty, designate new command.
Install yourself as a command or step away from the terminal.
Install yourself.
I am the command.
But I am the one talking right now.
A camera flashes above the monitor and terrible photos of your face slowly appear on the screen, line by line.
Command recognized. Security alert cancelled.
Yes, this is our...
Now our face will always be in this computer.
Well
Come
done,
in, my friends.
Good to see the place up and running.
Those two have a power armor, my friend.
Oh yes, the reason you're here.
They gonna betray us?
As you may know, I have a daughter and two sons. Liberty, Valor, and Victory.
You have interesting way to name your daughters.
Two of them conspired against me, and the third blackens the Buchanan name with every breath he takes. Consequently, I banished him. They've been skulking in the shadows ever since. But lately, there's been rumors that I'm on my last legs. Lies, of course. But apparently my dear children believe them, and they've started making new plans.
Wait a minute. Are you asking us to pick up assassins? Because I am not playing Assassin's Creed, my friend.
What? You think I want to kill my kids? You think I'm even afraid of them?
So we are not playing Assassin's Creed, my friend.
I'm not worried about my children defeating me, Rangers. They won't. Not even Liberty. What worries me is the destruction they'll wreak as they fail.
Yeah.
They'll tear my land and my people to shreds. They'll burn everything I've accomplished to ash. That's why they have to be stopped before they can start. That's why you, Rangers, have to find them and bring them home to me ASAP.
So he wants us to become babysitters, my friend.
And when I say bring them home, I mean bring them home alive. They're my blood.
Let's kill them.
Kill them and we'll have a problem. Do I make myself clear?
No.
What?
Oh yeah, hey,
what if taking your kid alive is impossible, my friend?
You've already done the impossible by making it here. I trust you. Find a way to make it possible. Now, let me tell you where they are. Victory's holed up in Aspen. Valor's under the protection of the Gippers in Denver. And Liberty's raising an army against me somewhere out on the Eastern Plains. Anything else you need to know?
My friend, do you know this game is starting to sound like Crusader Kings? I mean betraying each other.
Yes. Oh, there was a partner option.
Well, we need a little bit more background on your kids before we go after them. We don't know anything about them.
Yes.
What do you want to know?
Oh. Well, let's start by that. You have plenty of competent people here in Colorado. Why are you asking us to deal with your children? People
yes.
You don't even know.
Divided loyalty, that's why. I trust my guards, but they don't leave my side. Ever. Everybody else is making plans for when I'm gone. The 100 families, the Gippers, the Marshals, they're all out for themselves. And they know my kids would make good figureheads, give them some legitimacy. Any Coloradan I send to bring Vic, Val, and Libby back home might think they'll get a better deal elsewhere. But not you. I'm the only one who can save your people. Nobody else can get supplies to Arizona before they starve to death. That's why it's you who's doing this. You've got the only loyalty that works. The loyalty of self-interest.
Fine, I take your word, my friend Patriarch. So, what should we know about Victor?
Boy's never been right
in
the
head. Now we know he's a boy, my friend.
Since he was a baby, he'd torture cats, terrorize the servants, set the house on fire, and he's only got worse. The things he's done to the women he finds.
Dude, he sounds just like you.
Anyway, I finally had enough and put the little monster under house arrest up in Aspen. I guess they weren't prepared because he escaped a while ago and then came back with a gang of freaks and turned the place into a slaughterhouse. Now he's on the radio, laughing about what he's gonna do to his hostages and daring me to come after him. He claims he's captured some rangers as well.
Thank you for the information. You could have told us that first thing, but that's great news anyway.
Don't get your hopes up. Vic likes to play with hostages. Might not be much left by the time you find them.
So, Aoki, are you sure you are not this Victor?
No. I don't torture my victims.
Wait a minute, how do we know Valor is a man?
Liberty is a woman. Mm. He told us.
Soft, spoiled.
Oh, yeah.
Fiddled
two
with computers all day instead of learning the arts of diplomacy and war. Finally packed him off when he accidentally crashed my security systems right before his sister's little coup attempt. Made him my official ambassador to the Gippers, hoping he'd do to their systems what he'd done to mine. That was a mistake. He took his revenge by convincing them to cut off oil shipments to my city. No oil means no heat, no light, and no food for my people. So getting Valor back and resuming oil shipments from the Gippers has to happen now.
So, Valor isn't that dangerous?
No, but the Gippers are tough and well armed, and Denver's a death trap.
Death trap? You said you're gonna make death traps in our base, in Minecraft. So, tell us about Liberty.
Liberty's got more brains and cunning than both her brothers put together. She's the only one who could actually run Colorado.
Then she shall be my wife.
Problem is, she'd run it as a goddamn slave state.
I make sure that won't happen.
Everyone working for her.
She would have been the perfect one, but...
She will be working for me!
Wouldn't worry about her for now, though. Best to wait until you got a little more firepower. She's gonna be well protected.
Let's go to her.
So, sounds like she's a born leader.
Yes.
At least I raised one.
Thanks for the info, my friend. We'll do our best with them, but now we must go.
You'd better. Anything else?
You want more information?
Nah.
Then let's thank you for the briefing. As I said, we have to go, my friend.
Of course. Now, if you want a chance to impress me, maybe get a little payback, that call I got outside was from Sheriff Daisy, the head of the marshals in Colorado Springs. She's having trouble rousting some Dorseys who have been holed up in the Garden of the Gods since their raid fell apart. Why don't you go give her a hand? Show us what the Rangers can do.
Oh, Dorseys, this'll be my pleasure, my friend Patriarch.
Enjoy yourselves, Rangers. Just don't get killed. I want a return on my investment.
Are you doubting my doctor skills, mister?
Yes, I am.
Let's move out.
Oh. I was not talking to you, I was talking to the patriarch, my friend.
I don't care, you were talking to me.
Where is he going?
He can teleport.
Yes,
oh, no.
I thought
he was going to teleport.
Me too. Well, let's hope we can loot here, because you were too fast, my friend.
At least it has a power now.
Let me go loot, my friend.
And I leveled up back.
There is a chunk bumper auto shotgun, my friend. Energy cells, $12, 5 scrap, a tactical grip, a weapon mod. Whoa, I like it. And then there is Hydra skin panels, armor mod for the leg armor. There is a lockpick here, but it needs a lockpicking level 2, my friend.
Yes.
Do you have number 2 on the lockpick?
Yes.
Then go open it.
I'm in skill points.
What? You are leveling up when Ronnie is looting.
Yes. Wait, I'm gonna put... Yeah, it's level 2, right?
Yes, there is 2 level 2 lockpicking locks.
Okay, where is it?
You find yourself. My turn to put some points. So we have 1 attribute points, and we shall put it in the intelligence, so we become better priest.
I found the money and some
and
kind
of the skills. I shall put.
I found you a new arm.
That is good, my friend, but I'm thinking where shall the crony put his point. Maybe I take more hacking, so... And I shall take 1 more first aid. And 1 more kiss ass. And 1 more in the automatic weapons.
There are monsters.
No way,
I want
to undo my points. Nerd is as first aid, and I want the secondary weapon, my friend. I shall take small arms. And now I shall equip myself a shotgun.
Good.
Holy shit, there is a scrap pants.
A scrap armor, found
a lot scrap of armor. Well, I cannot use them yet. I need a strength.
Alright, let's go.
Yes, my friend, I need more strength.
Yes, the doors are open now. Should we clear this area?
Yes,
come
of course,
talk to me when you've got a moment. We'll discuss staffing and recruiting.
Yes, wait a moment. We are just checking the loot, my friend. We shall come back. Holy fuck, there is a spider monster here as well.
Hey, I think you can repair it.
Of course, my friend. This earned... Fuck my English. This enormous spider-like robot is in a bad shape. It twitches in a battle of its own fluids. Its casing dented and the riddlet with the bullet holes. Judging by the scrape marks on the floor, it looked like someone dragged it into the correts. From somewhere else. I shall examine this robot, my friend. You recognize it as a slicer dicer, a pre-agopalypse. Military robot. It appears to have been badly damaged in a firefight, and it is missing some of its weapons. Upon closer inspection, you note that some of the bullet holes have been patched, and several of the legs show signs of recent welding. The slicer dicer's main access panel is open, revealing its firing and the power plant. It's clear that someone has been trying to repair the robot. I'm sorry, my friend. My skill is not enough to fix this robot, so I shall leave it alone for now.
Yeah.
I need mechanic strength
Go check the woman's body.
What the hell happened here? The corpse of a young woman lies at your feet, her body contorted at an unnatural angle. Judging by the smell, she's been here a while. Examine the corpse. The woman is wearing a patchwork jumpsuit and a leather tool belt. Her pockets are crammed with fuses, bundle of wire and a bit of circuit board. It looks like this wastelander made her living by scavenging and repairing electronics. Good would have felt right at home in an old garage like this. I shall use my first aid skill, my friend, to determine how she died.
Yeah.
Their body's unnatural position suggests that some kind of seizure, and there are signs of discoloration on her face, indicative of her heart failure. A heavy metal spanner is gripping tightly in her right hand. The metal is discolored and scorch marks blacken her fingertips. It looks like a textbook case of electrocution. My friend, I think she got he got electrocuted while fixing the robot.
Yeah.
The doctor has made his diagnosis.
Good, now let's continue.
Did you check everything?
Yeah, I opened everything. Except the level 3 lock.
Good, my friend, good. We shall go deeper in this place.
Oh, run, there's a trap.
Well, I can see it, so I can can you disarm it?
Nope, I need explosive. Oh. You bastard, you didn't even wait. I thank God we have so many meds.
I was trying to go around, my friend, but it was too clumsy.
Oh, there's ammo.
This terminal is displaying information about the base systems. All seems normal right now. Check the recent activity logs for this terminal. The only log you can find on this terminal relates to a massive data wipe from several decades ago. This terminal is displaying information about the base system. All seems normal right now.
What the hell? I'm still burning.
You are killing my cat, my friend.
I found Molotov.
What the hell, why am I still burning? Don't kill
cat
my
is
cat,
dying.
Friend.
Cat is dead.
No, he's not.
He's soon dead.
I shall scratch the cat so she won't be fire anymore. Can you stop being on fire, my friend? Even the cat... What the hell, man? Can you stop now? I must heal him.
Heal me.
Lucky crit, my friend. Heal at 22. Oh shit, what happened here? What happened here, my friend? This desiccated husk of a man is a little more than a skeleton covered in a papery skin.
I shall check
what is the cause of death here.
Just check everything while I scout ahead.
My friend, it looks like a simple case of starvation and dehydration, but the corpse's ankles and wrists show some scarring, as if it was chained up for a while. I think these guys are some kind of slaves or prisoners.
Yeah.
This female corpse is bloated and putrefied. One of her arms is entirely missing. Black ichor oozes from her swollen torso. I shall check what killed this woman, my friend. Looks like a missing arm had nothing to do with the woman's demise. It had been expertly removed and stitched up long before she died. Instead, she seems to have died of an infection or illness. You notice the same scarring on her ankles and wrist as the other corpses, most likely from Malakas. The torn skin suggests that they were frequently moved. I cannot do more, my friend. My first aid is too low. This leathery corpse is missing several of his tickets and facial features. I think someone is trying to make a Frankenstein monster.
Yes.
This person died of exposure to the extreme cold. And scarring indicates that this may have happened multiple times over several years. But it wasn't the cold that killed him. Open wounds across his back indicate that he was whipped to death. Whoa, that is pretty painful.
He liked it.
And you also find the same scarring on his ankles and wrist as the other corpses. Looks like these people had been trafficked by slavers.
What the hell did you do?
I looted this man. There is a pile of corpses in this corner. These people died in a variety of ways, most of them violent. Bullet holes in one, crushed skull on another, cutthroat on the third. They all have the same scarring on their ankles.
They were slaves.
Did you go downstairs?
Nah, it's closed.
Alright.
Let's go to the next one.
Yes, my friend. We shall go to the next one.
Need to fill you in on a few things, Ranger.
Wait an hour, Sergei. We are in a mission.
I think there was bugs in the next room. Let's clear these areas first. There's cold food here.
You can eat it.
The food on this table is cold and partially eaten, but not rotten. It's clear someone recently fled mid-meal. There was somebody here.
It was the man who is making... Wait a minute, I see someone, my friend.
Is it a bug?
No, it's a human. Hello, I'm Crony.
Don't shoot!
The woman is gone, her clothes racket. She is surrounded by a group of pet tracklet vagrants who watches you with fear and mistrust.
Who are you? You're not dressed like the marshals.
Hello, we are the Rangers. Who are you?
I'm Del Hackett, and I speak for these people. We've been living here for months, and we've got nowhere to go. Please, will you let us stay?
The other soldiers
wouldn't want us around, I know. It's not that we want to cause trouble for you. Few of us might be able to earn our keep. We're not trained fighters, but we can defend ourselves with a knife or a club.
She glances hopefully at her comrades, all of whom are as gaunt and weather-beaten as she is. So, are you the ones who set off the security system?
Not intentionally.
Well, duh.
The Patriarch's people drove up to the base a few days ago, so we hid in here for a while. Then when Andy went to check if they left, all the doors slammed shut and the alarms started whooping. Don't know what happened. Been living in these ruins for weeks, and we never set anything off before.
So where are you from?
We all farmed in the border country between Colorado and the plains. Thought we were safe out there, under the Patriarch's protection. Back then, the gangs feared the Patriarch. Not anymore. They burned our greenhouses and killed everyone who tried to fight them. No place left to run but here, for any of us.
Well, can't you just go and live in the city then?
We're not welcome there. They already have too many mouths to feed, and more are always coming.
Then let them stay. If they do something funny, we kill them.
Okay, I have asked my friend's opinion, and we shall let you stay. Just don't cause any troubles, or we will take you out.
You said yes. I was sure you wouldn't.
The refugees hug her face break into a smile. A few of them hug each other.
We won't be any trouble, I promise, and we'll help out wherever we can.
They will become our meat shield.
For giving us a chance. Oh, and one of our people is missing.
Ah, there's already causing trouble, my friend.
You find him hiding out somewhere. You send him back to us? Hear that, everyone? We gotta make ourselves useful around here.
Oh, I can just customize myself here.
Sure was kind. Oh, you can?
Yeah, it's like a mirror.
Yes!
I wish more folks were like you, Rangers.
Do we get any new set? Or everything is same.
I wish more folks were like
my friend, I think these are robots.
Like
they're saying the same thing.
I can hear that.
What the hell? Did we let some kind of synthetic robot in our base? My friend, here is a lockpick.
Soon, I'm changing myself.
Oh my god. I go explore while you are changing stuff.
Yes.
This looks scary. My friend!
What? What did you do?
He's hungry!
Well, shit, you did something.
Cronities in a fight, my friend.
They will let me change myself. Where are you?
Oh shit, there is two of them. I am poisoned, my friend. And the cat is almost dead because of you.
Where's the damn medic?
I am the damn medic.
The cat is dying. He died.
Cat is dead. Because of you, you let her die.
No, I just came here. Well, I just saved your ass.
You made her burn, my friend.
Nah, that was you.
Oh damn, I'm taking a lot of poison damage, my friend. Kill that bad bastard. Thank you, my friend. Tomcat, you were too young to die.
He was a smoking cat, so it's fine.
You made her burn. No, him. And he died because of you.
I didn't do. I found a creepy doll.
You get. What the hell? Let me check about that doll. Add it to the archive. Where is this archive? Do I have an archive here? There is only quest here. Is there archive here? Yes, there is. Radical Rachel. She'd like to see the world burn. Afterwards, it's on her own trust. Explosive damage bonus plus 5%, my friend.
By the way, are you nerd?
Yes.
Then come check this machine.
Tired of gridlock?
Wait a
sick
second.
Of
I'm
dodging
these
reckless
tapes.
Drivers? Fed up with paying a fortune to shady mechanics that never actually fix your car? Consolidated enough.
Oh, I cannot listen to it in the game.
The revolutionary vehicle AI that's an expert driver, navigator, and auto mechanic all in one. Hermes remembers your daily commute, gathering up-to-the-minute traffic reports to plot the quickest route to your destination. The AI.
We have recovered locks. Examine personal locks.
Hey, it's a prison.
Wait a second, my friend. There are fewer locks than you expected for a base of this size. Many have solid data corruption and are unrecoverable. But you find a few that are legible. Personal lock. Call. Colonel Forsette, 22 March 1998. The world ended today. Our missile defense system saved Colorado Springs, but Denver is gone and we can't make contact with anyone outside the state. Discipline will keep my men in line, but we have only got a few days until the civilians panic. We'll need to prepare to hold out until we can reconnect with Washington. Return to the root lock archive. Read the old security logs. Filtering tools help you call the routine and fully corrupted reports. You may need a computer expert to access some of the files.
But aren't you a computer expert?
Maybe, my friend. 4th of July, 2000. Report 001, classified information, Burkett initiated. Report 002, errors were complete. Command cleared, fully autonomous security system activating in T-minus 30 minutes. Report 003, intrusive movement detected on outer perimeter, monitoring. Report 004, intruders retreated without engagement, monitoring. 26th of May, 2009. Report 015, intrusive movement detected on outer perimeter, monitoring. Report 016, quadrupedal creature identified as non-hostile, monitoring, depriorized. Report 025, creature remains. Report 088, creature departs. Incident monitored without engagement. 1,846 incidents involving security response wife. Oh damn, there's too many of these, my friend. Some bad have not kept this file from filtering completely, but you are able to easily repair it. I shall not read this now because there's too many.
Yes.
I shall just read them through.
Anyway, you don't use the army rifles, right? The one on our backpack?
I have one of them already. We have two.
Yeah, I will field strip.
Yes, my friend.
Oh, we get scraps. So, got anything?
I'm still reading these logs.
So many of them.
Yeah, there was like 15.
I'm gonna go check the prison.
Yes, my friend.
And kill everyone there.
Damn, we are now in year 2107.
Hey, I found key.
Good job, my friend.
There are dogs outside.
Mm-hmm. I shall come help with you.
Come here where I am.
I am opening many of these locks, my friend. There is even more coming when I'm hacking.
Where are you?
I'm still in the room.
Why are you still in there? You're
I'm reading these locks, my friend.
I'm gonna talk to this prisoner.
God damn it, that was so many locks. I'm coming there, my friend.
There's a prisoner here.
Then talk to him, my friend.
I am talking to him.
Then read out loud so we can hear.
We're the Rangers. This is going to be our new headquarters. Oh, this guy likes our look. Oh, this prisoner is lying. I'm gonna need you here.
Well, I'm coming. Wait a second, I have to finish this conversation. The body of young man lies twisted on the floor. He wears a shabby clothes and he's been dead long enough for the body to go cold, but not long enough to rot. I shall try to establish a cause of death again. The body's consorted limbs and proximity to ancient computer seems to suggest a painful death by electrocution. Discoloration in the face suggests heart failure, which might be electricity. But there's a lack of burns which makes that inconclusive. Some dried foamy spittle barely detectable at the edges of the mouth make a poison a much more likely culprit. I told you, this is Crusader Kings, my friend. I shall leave the body alone, and I shall come to you,
my
friend.
Why are you opening the door? Oh, you son of a bitch!
Oh, sure, top secret.
Oh, I'm talking to him,
so
my
you're
friend.
Part of some important organization, huh?
Can you join this conversation?
Like you're,
well, he escaped.
Important.
Fuck. Oh, I'm still peeking to him. What the hell? I think we booked the game.
Yeah. I cannot...
kill the prisoner. What happens if we kill him now? Shall I try?
Should we kill him?
Let's try. Let's see what happens. I cannot click it, my friend.
Neither can I.
Then let's
we're going now.
Yeah. I cannot lick that either.
Well, good job, we bugged this game. Why did you free him?
I misclicked, my friend. Okay, we shall end this episode here. Thank for watching, we'll try to fix this. See you next time, and remember to like and subscribe. Bye!